London was the only area to escape when buses were deregulated in 1986. Now there are government plans to bring the capital in line with the rest of the country by the early 1990s. It's claimed customers will benefit from services more carefully geared to their needs. But a report out today by the London Regional Passengers Watchdog Committee warns that deregulation in other areas has simply led to extra services on money-making routes, while late-night and weekend services are almost non-existent. It also claims the already congested capital simply will not be able to cope with extra buses fighting for custom on the busiest routes. But hardest hit will be the passengers.
We do have a bus service that is integrated into public transport in the rest of London. It's integrated to the Underground and integrated to British Rail. If deregulation comes along, that integration is at risk, and Travel Card is very much at risk.
Passengers living in areas like Harlow, where private bus companies are already the norm, say services are erratic and confusing.
You're waiting at a bus stop. You can't get one. They all seem to be up here at the same time. There's no organisation with the times.
You don't know where they're going because they don't show anything up on the front. Everything's a town centre.
Confusing. It's very hard to find out where to get a bus, what time.
Pensioners as non-paying passengers are said to be worst hit by the private firms.
A lady got into the bus and she asked him, did this bus go to a certain destination? And he turned around and says, lady, if you want to go there, you've got to pay. We're not a charity organisation in front of a bus full of people. And the person that he spoke to was 85 years of age.
The situation's now so bad, the local council stepped in to provide services on non-essential routes, and even companies admit the passengers can't win.
I think that their pursuit of the market in the context of public transport is one that benefits merely the owners of the companies and not the passengers and not those workers that work in the industry.
The passenger watchdog report highlights the fact that bus fares in London have stayed lower than any other area since deregulation, and demand has also increased when it's dropped elsewhere. The message is London buses aren't perfect, but deregulation isn't the answer. Sharon Doughty for Thames News.